The Philippine senators vowed to address issues hounding the country's basic education system, beginning with mental health and a huge learning gap among students. Jasmine Romero reports.
There is no denying that learning during a pandemic is a challenge. In Tuesday's Senate session, the Committee on Basic Education Chairman, Senator Sherwin Gatchalian, cited some concerning studies that underscore the huge learning gap of students.
90% of our 10-year-olds cannot read and understand simple, read or understand a simple story. And this is from the World Bank. USAID also conducted what they call a rapid assessment. Only 40% in the NCR is grade ready. For grade 2, it's only 36%. In grade 3 is 25%. This determines the readiness of our students in terms of reading. If you go to the rural areas, it's even worse.
To address this, he proposed Senate Bill 1604, or the Aral Program Act, which calls for an academic recovery and accessible learning program to help students keep up with their studies. This would be a continuing program for students where they will be assisted to improve on the three subjects. Senator Coco Pimentel questioned the need for such a program.
Because what will happen is the student covered by the Aral program, it being now mandatory, will be required to spend extra hours. The intervention should have already been made during the regular class hours.
While Gatchalian acknowledged Pimentel's remarks, he argued the need for interventions to help struggling students catch up with their peers. Another alarming issue stakeholders hope to address is the mental health of both teachers and students. According to the Department of Education, the number of students who attempted to take their life is rising. In 2021 alone, over 400 students committed suicide.
Ang direction po natin ngayon, kasi minado tayo, hindi naman tayo talagang expert sa mental health. So we want to seek out yung mental health or mental wellness experts natin at para makakuha tayo ng idea kung ano yung effective na programs at the school level, hindi lang yung basta polisiya, pero yung talagang implement natin at the school level.
In this situation, guidance counselors play a critical role. Unfortunately, there aren't enough of them. Currently, the ratio of guidance counselors to students is 1 to over 13,000. The ideal ratio is 1 to 500. Senators agree improving the pay and welfare of teachers will go a long way in managing the mental health of our educators.
I'll make it simple. Happy teachers means happy students. Isa pa po sa nakadagdag sa mental health problem ng mga estudyante, kasi po yung mga teachers ay overwhelmed. Sometimes they are obliged to teach na subjects that are not their specialty. Hindi nila tatanggap yung kanilang MOOE. Agot na nga sila, problemado, and maliit ang sweldo.
Under the Senate Bill 379, or Basic Education Mental Health and Well-being Promotion Act, teachers will also be provided with counseling or psychological assistance. In the meantime, an education expert believes using the mother tongue as medium of instruction will help boost the critical thinking of students. This comes as Vice President and concurrent Education Secretary Sara Duterte seeks a review of the implementation of the mother tongue-based multilingual education policy.
Yan ang kakulangan, ano, yung confidence at kakayanan. At matagal nang tinatabi, 1925 pa, nung first study ng public school system ng 1925, kaya behind yung mga Filipino children ng 2 grades ay dahil puro English sa klase. You are not using what they know, ano?
Jasmine Romero, ABS-CBN News.